Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, champions and paladins of the realm. My name is Ray Day. Joined today is my co-commentator, Vox, joining me today, and we'll be going into the Losers Finals right now. On the left-hand side of your scoreboard screen, we've got Wizdude onto the Ruckus, Graham onto the Androxus, Mike Man 2508 onto Knessa, Reveling onto Pip, and Snakey Snake onto Barrack, representing Team Zenith Black. Whereas on the right-hand side of the board, you've got Saravok onto the Pip, Dramamine onto the Drogo, Sexy Savior on the Ruckus, Rob Forb on Barrack, and Weeaboo Jones onto the Fernando. What do you think about these picks, these team comps, Tattle?
This is weird to see. We're seeing IC Grey come in with the same comp from last game, but we're seeing Zenith Black change up so much here. Reveling and Wizdude, the only original picks here. We're seeing an Androxus, we're seeing Knessa and Snakey Snakes on that Barrack rather than Eevee. It's all over the place right now. I tell you who is all over. It's Zenith Black all over the side of IC Grey right now.
Mm-hmm. Zenith Black looking very strong. They've got, now it's a 3v3, so it looks like both have two members down. Snakey Snake did just respawn, so he's going to be heading his way back to the capture point in just a moment. But Graham and Wizdude. Mike Man picks up Rob Ford there while Graham and Wizdude on the point safely just chilling out before Pip comes in from the backside and the high ground to go ahead and start aggressing onto that point. But they're going to have to get in there with some pressure to get Wizdude and Snakey Snake with that Barrack shield off. And here comes Fernando right on cue.
This is a Knessa's dream right now. Igloo is the first point. There is no pressure on her right now whatsoever. Look at that. Now it's Dramamine starting to aggress onto her. But nice juke there with the teleporter. The rest of the team finally come back to support him. And Dramamine taken out of the sky. That's Zenith Black taking this imposing lead on the first point.
Very imposing. All teammates on a three or higher streak on the side of Zenith Black, whereas Identity Crisis Gray not exactly going the same way that they found their other counterparts on the black side of things. Identity Crisis to be doing. And it looks like, you know, whatever it is, we're seeing Zenith Black have some very strong point capture fights here. And I think that this is really showing, I think, maybe the talent level of their squad in comparison to potentially Identity Crisis. We'll see. It's very early to tell, but, Zenith Black taking it pretty convincingly.
Mike Man's doing a great job with his Knessa, especially. I mean, only getting pressured every now and then because the rest of the team is causing so much threat. And because of that, he's just able to keep shooting away in the back line, get the kills that he needs to. The people who aggress onto him, Sexy Savior, he gets taken down. Severok, too. And aggressing towards this Knessa is just being punished so hard and so well right now. Mike Man is so far back, but look at this. Looks like Weeaboo Jones. He doesn't even care about the payload that's slowly pushing forward. He just wants this kill on Knessa, but that transporter distance, that is so far away.
Really nice play. And we've seen Mike Man showcase already the effectiveness of that transporter with the distance. Not only that, the levels, the adjustment in the gaps, right? Because you can throw it up onto a ledge, and even if you pretend to jump down onto the ledge, after that transporter actually activates, you'll go back onto the ledge. Not only that, you will heal up for 40% of your maximum health. I mean, can keep a Knessa very tricky, very alive if you know how to use it well. So that transporter definitely coming into play. Mike Man still on a 7 streak here as Graham takes the lead with a 10 streak on Team Zenith Black.
And without a way to punish this Knessa, with Mike Man just being able to do whatever he wants. He's in heaven right now. Graham picks up the kill from the help of Mike Man, but here comes the flank again. Graham with a double. Weeaboo Jones finally comes down to try and shut down this Knessa, but it doesn't even matter. Look at the payload. It's already on the point. Wizdude pops the Hexafire to keep Weeaboo Jones out of harm's way, keeping his Knessa safe, but it doesn't even matter. You have to send so much for that Knessa that they're just going to take the payload.
Amazing plays. Graham takes that from a 10 streak to a 14 streak, and Snakey Snake right beside him with a 10 streak of his own. You're seeing resiliences picked up by all members of Team Zenith Black, meaning that they don't want to have to deal with any CC. But of course, that's not going to affect the CC coming out from Pip. But will it affect Dramamine's knockback?
I think it affects the knockback, but I think it's odd here because, you know, it doesn't cancel the chicken out, but it definitely does counter it. And I think they were expecting it to come out, but chicken's already been used. They saw that at the end of the last fight, so this resilience isn't going to have any effect until later in the fight. And right now, I see Gray, they're making a comeback on this one. Dragonmind and Sexy Savior, they pick up the kills. Mike Man does return, but now he's in a dangerous position. Here comes the Dragon Punch, jumped away last seconds by Reveling as he dodges that one. Graham with a reflect, and it's Weeaboo Jones who's going forwards. He finds another Graham getting killed by Sexy Savior. Weeaboo Jones picks up the third kill of this fight, and it's Icy Gray coming ahead of this fight. Resilience completely not working out for them, and all of those blast shields on the side of Icy Gray just doing so much more.
I mean, I can't see any other reason to have resilience unless it affects the Drogo's knockback. So we have to assume that's what happens. But still, even the case, we're not finding it to be very effective here. And you're saying that. And when you pick a card like resilience, which is extremely specific, if you don't get your value's worth, you don't get your money's worth, you are basically two cards to three cards.
Confirm that resilience does not affect the knockback on expectorate.
So what are they getting it for? I don't understand.
It's the only thing that it could really help with is this chicken. But
it doesn't.
I don't think there was any communication. It doesn't nullify it completely, but it reduces the duration of the chicken to one second. I believe.
No, it can't. It's a minimum of 2 seconds.
Yeah, it's a minimum of 2 seconds, but the duration of chicken without any reduction, I think, is a lot longer than 2 seconds.
Oh, yes. Yes, but I don't know. We need some, see if we can get some verification on that.
There goes the Dragon Punch. Yeah. Mike Man taken down on the high ground. And that's one way to get rid of a Kinesa when you're trying to make this push. That's going to allow them to keep this payload rolling. No trouble coming through from him. Snakey Snake taken down. There's the Mega Turret taking down Rolford. Great play there by him. But the high ground control coming through from the side of Icy Gray is so much stronger. They take 2 kills. Graham does take down Sexy Savior inside the base. And it's Mike Man set back up on the battlements. But against that, Fernando can't do any damage. The payload is finally stalled out here as the rest of the team start to respawn. Icy Gray, they're going to have to break this defense once again.
Yeah, and they're doing a pretty decent job at it so far. The payload being pushed in. Icy Gray having a chance to go ahead and even things up here. And as the payload almost gobs, you see unbelievable step there in front of it. Snakey Snake, Graham, and Wizdu going ahead and putting out all of their cannons. Just basically trying to say, let's shoot this thing down. We do not need any activity coming in from Sexy Savior. And is that a triple kill coming out?
That's a triple for Sexy Savior. Doesn't get the quad saving play at the end. Dramamine picks up 1 kill. Sexy Savior did go down. It's 2 versus 3 on this point. Respawn's coming through as well. Mike Man is back into this one. 20 seconds remaining. Pip trying to rain down shots. Dramamine, he finds Mike Man, finds the kill, finds the second one into Reveling. Wizdude, he finds the double of his own onto Weeaboo and Dramamine. That's the Drogo's down. Graham picks up several. It's just Barrack left on this one. And they all step off the point.
They stepped off. Oh my god, they stepped off. They had the defense. They had it. They had the defense. They just moved away from the payload, all three at the same time. There was no communication.
I don't know what happened. It was even Graham using a nether dash there as well to step off. There's no other word apart from misplay there. I mean, maybe they were expecting the Barrack you have to stay on the payload.
Yeah, that's a misplay. That's a misplay. I mean, we can't figure out resilience yet. That is figured about. We can figure that out. That is just a misplay. There is no advantage whatsoever of stepping away from that point when you're like 1 second away from defending successfully. And it's like your team is all right there. There's no benefit to that. It's just a misplay, lack of communication. You see how valuable that can be in these competitive games. And who knows? That ties the series. Maybe that changed the outcome of this game. We'll have to wait and see. Of course, as things get pretty tight here in the losers finals, looking to see who's going to make it into the grand finals to go ahead and face Ronan, the kind of top seed we've all been considering them so far in this tournament. But Zenith Black and Icy Gray want their chance.
This has just changed things around so much. We saw Icy Gray struggle on that first point so much, get stomped out completely. Now it's the other way around in these last two fights as they just dominate the side of Zenith Black. And look at this, 4 resiliences.
Again. I mean, they must know something we don't.
In comparison to the full blast shields on the side of Icy Gray, which is just allowing, it's just allowing them to win every single fight right now.
Yeah, I mean, I just don't understand. Icy Gray coming at it with such a better approach, and they go up 6-4. I mean, the resilience, I just don't get it. I don't get it. Even if it works to make it from 2 seconds to 1 second, who cares? You get chicken. You're a chicken for 1 second. That's enough. You run around as a chicken for 1 second. That's enough to have the effect. It's not as much as taking off. How was it? 15%, 25% damage reduction from shots over 350? I mean,
yeah, it's a
that's
lot.
So much more effective.
I tell you what, again, something like Graves being canceled out here, Severok does that much damage. I think the only people not affected by that sexy savior and Weeaboo Jones, and look at this.
It's
aggressive right now from the side of Icy Gray. They over-aggress into the base, however, but all the while, Payload still pushing forwards.
Yeah, and Graham is here, kind of the last man standing, trying to just be near this Payload so it doesn't move any farther, but forced another step away. Dragon Punch comes out, and it does take out Reveling, who's just got a kill onto Rob Ford, but then goes back to his base, thanks and courtesy to Dramamine. Graham getting the kill onto Saravok as this push continues. Weeaboo Jones go ahead and escorting that, making Graham get out of there or get taken down. Another step comes right as I expected, and now the Payload is almost being converted here. Joe goes up into the air, but gets taken down with an aerial shot by Pip. That was hype, Reveling. Those aren't easy to hit. Nice play there by Reveling, who's defending his Payload with all he's got, trying to make sure this game doesn't go 8-4.
Rob Ford pops the Mega Turret, finds one kill with that. He gets taken down by Reveling. It looks like Graham left to defend the Payload right now whilst the rest of the team try and get the high ground control. They're now allowed to set Mike Man. Mike Man getting his setup that he wants. Wizdude finds the kill. Mike Man gets Weeaboo Jones down, and they manage to clean out Icy Gray for the first time, I think, in a while, out of their base and regain control.
Spring cleaning, and that has to do with getting Icy Gray out of their base, and they just did that successfully. Zenith Black going to try and hold off, get an extra point, make this game 5-6, and then of course give themselves a much better chance to contest winning this first game in the losers finals rather than going down to 8-4, which would be a pretty hard deficit
back from. Hexafire comes out from Wizdude. He gets a double kill with that, but the thing is, that's now not there for the next fight. This is going to be awkward for the next kills coming through. Revelin and Graham, however, they find the kills they need on the Payload on the defense. If they can find this kill onto Rob Ford, overtime will not go through. Does manage to find it, and the defense does fail, but look at the ultimate charges right now. Oh,
yeah,
boy.
It's 2-1 in favor of Team Icy Gray.
If we see resiliences.
The resiliences picked up a couple of them. Three of them now. Maybe
three.
Four. It's not going to be four. It's going to be three, but five blast shields. Not one, not two, not three, not four.
Mike Man
five.
Does change to the blast shields, which, I mean, that's understandable, if anyone. You know, he's having to deal with Dramamine all the time. He's the only one he's having to deal with. And those rockets do a lot of damage. Understandable. I still can't. This resilience doesn't make any sense. There is no reason to take it.
I mean, it's not that it's a bad card, but it's a specific card that's kind of like building like a weakening curse with no healers. You know, if you understand Smite, it's kind of like going for anti-healing with not really a lot of healers. And that's kind of what they're doing. There isn't this kind of dramatic CC that's changing the fight. So we're not really sure why they're picking up 100% CC reduction.
It isn't even Pip who's doing any of the work this fight. Sexy Savior with a triple kill. The savior of the team right now as they're making this huge comeback from that last point, from that first point that we saw. Icy Gray wiping out Zenith Black so far in this fight.
Right, right. And I like actually Cauterize actually coming out on some of these characters. Sexy Savior, Weeaboo Jones, kind of got that AoE damage or that very fast, very easy damage to just apply at least a stack of so that the healing does not become effective from the side of Reveling on the Pip for Team Zenith Black. And so I do agree with some of those pickups there, going for the anti-healing coming out from Pip. Who can heal? Who can do damage? Who has mobility? Very strong character.
And I mean, point just goes straight over to Icy Gray. They're not able to get through the front line here of the zoning picks. Dramamine, Sexy Savior, Severok, they're all very far forwards, holding them all off. And they can't win these fights. They don't have blast shields. They lose these fights straight up because of their card choices.
They are losing these fights as a a point to understand. You know, these fights are being lost really because of strategic choices that these teams are making. There's a lot of times when actual man-to-man, let me shoot you or you shoot me, we're one-on-one in the West, and I'm basically bringing a gun and you're bringing one too. That matters, you know, just pure up shooting skill and accuracy. But then there are tactical decisions, team strategic moments that really can change the face of a game or change the way a team is successful. And this is what we're seeing be the biggest outcome here. I think the choices these teams are making is just proving so effective.
Mega turret's come out, but that's going to be blocked out. Another mega turret in return from Robford. That should be able to take down Wizdude with that Hexafire. Indeed, Sexy Savior picks up the double kill. An Icy Gray takedown Zenith Black in what was surely an upset in this one.
Yeah, unbelievable play there by Icy Gray. You know what? I'm trying to just make sure we have everything correct here. I kind of got flipped up on my side, but let's just make sure that. So pretty much we're looking at Icy Gray showing that their idea of actually looking at this game. Being so successful in the choices they're making in terms of these burn cards, what do we really see how that's impacting? Like, how, you know, what seems like a very simple decision, how can that really impact a game so dramatically like we've been seeing?
I mean, we saw the first fight, Zenith Black all over that. Arguably, it is the point that Kanessa is strongest on, you know, Igloo. I really don't like the Kanessa pick on this map anyway, because, you know, Igloo is your strongest point. The other ones you really suffer on. That's two out of three that you are not doing well on. But, you know, it's rough there, but they were doing so well. They completely wiped out Icy Gray, did great, and then I think they managed to... Did they make the payload push from there? I think they converted it. But,
yeah.
Then we saw card choices, burn cards come through, and that resilience, I mean... I thought to myself, if this was going to be made, maybe they were expecting the next point fight to be really important on Ultimates and the chicken to come through. But even then, that seemed like a mistake because the chicken had been popped right at the end of that fight. You know, mm-hmm. That communication should have been made. They should have known that the chicken was 0% charge at that point. So even then, resilience, not going to do much. We thought for a second it might be a counter to the Drogos knockback, but it was clear to see from that first round it wasn't having any effect. So at that point,
right.
Why do you still take it in the next round?
Well, I mean, in that point, I want to give these players the benefit of the doubt and say that Zenith Black made it all the way to the Losers Finals. Clearly, they know how to play. They know about the game. What is their thought process? Like, I would want to interview with these guys right now and say, why are you all, like, not just one of you, why are you all as a team deciding, let's all get resiliences?
Yeah.
Because that would be interesting, because maybe they're seeing something and seeing the game in a different way than we are. Because, you know, oftentimes, you know, commentators will say certain things and put a mentality onto a character that or a player that they may not have. So let's understand that they are playing the game. We are looking at it from the perspective above it all. So we may not have some of the internal information that they have. But again,
yeah.
kind of hard for us to figure it out right now.
And maybe Pip wasn't having an impact in that. I mean, we look at that game and I'm thinking to myself, Pip isn't having the impact on this game that the other characters are having. They are losing every single 1v1 because of the lack of blast shields. But again, maybe Pip wasn't having a carry impact on that game because of the resilience. Maybe it was more of a... You know, they were losing the trades 1v1, sure, but if they'd have gone blast shields, maybe at the same time they would have lost a huge Pip ultimate. It's hard to say, but
exactly,
certainly boggling to watch. Just not seeming to work out for Zenith Black, and it's going to be interesting to see how they adapt in the second game of the series.
And as you'll become more aware in the professional scene, a lot of players, a lot of teams go for the safe pick, the guaranteed damage or guaranteed damage reduction, rather than the kind of hype play or specific niche thing, unless it's very, very strong against the exact comp they're against. You see it a lot in Smite, and you'll definitely be seeing it in Paladins, I believe, in the future. I don't know if this was a good choice. I mean, Team Icy Gray took the blast shields, which is guaranteed damage reduction, versus, you know, the potential of reducing some crowd control. We're not even sure how much of an effect that had in the game, but clearly it wasn't enough as Zenith Black goes down 0-1 in this first game of the Losers Finals. You guys stay right where you are. We'll be back with game two in just a moment, and we'll see you in a sec. Welcome back, champions, paladins of the realm. My name is Rene, and I'm joined today with my co-commentator, Tattle, and we're going to be taking you through the second game of the Losers Finals versus Zenith Black and Team IC Gray. On the left-hand side, the left team IC Gray. Playing Pip on that team is Saravok. Dramamine will be running Drogos. Weeaboo Jones onto the Fernando. Sexy Savior on the Ruckus and Rob Ford on the Barrack. Whereas Wizdude on Team Zenith Black will be on Ruckus. Graham will be on Androxus himself. Mike Man will be on Barrack. Snakey Snake on the Eevee and Reveling onto the Pip. A couple of changes now. Eevee, we're seeing back in the game.
Yeah, Eevee coming back, and a lot of the composition changes going back to what it was before. I think Zenith Black, after that last game, the pounding they took with the new picks they went for, they're going back to their old ways, picking up those characters they knew before. And the kill's going even right now. Reveling making the lead in IC Gray's favor right now, however. So they pick up that extra kill. Actually, it's Zenith Black's favor. It's Wizdude picks up another onto Dramamine, and Weeaboo Jones. It's double kill on him.
Yeah, it's a nice job there by Weeaboo Jones to try to go ahead and clear some space for his teammates, but doesn't work out enough because Wizdude able to go ahead and get a few kills, make that four, in fact, and get himself on a little bit of a streak. And now his teammates should be going ahead, trying to aggress, get them off their horses, and make sure that Zenith Black actually, Identity Crisis can't get back on this point without a huge contest coming in through the corridors.
I see Gray, they're starting to push through, however, they push Ruckus back. Severok finds the first kill onto Graham. There goes the rest of the team pushing through the choke point. Weeaboo Jones does get taken down. Reveling finds a nice flask onto Severok, and Wizdude cleans up Rodford. The push hasn't worked out. I see Gray, Wizdude with the double kill. Sexy Savior does take him out, but I see Gray, they're taken down. Zenith Black, they take the first point.
Looking strong in the beginning, Zenith Black over on this map here, the left-hand side, actually potentially the right-hand side, depending on how you're looking at it, of the map, and it's a really nice open point. A lot of options for that Eevee to go ahead, blink in, get out, back undercover. Drogos as well to fly up and just take advantage of being able to spot his enemies easily and really have no place to go ahead and cover themselves. So really nice play there by Zenith Black to take that first point.
Nice play by them, but the stuck in this choke point. Weeaboo Jones holding it nicely. Ice Storm comes out in the side, but really wasted because Dramamine just going to jump out of the way of it. Boosters away, out of danger. Sexy Savior finds Reveling. They're just trying to avoid the rest of the fight right now. Graham does find one. Snakey Snake another. And it looks like, actually, I see Gray. They've pushed too far forwards. The aggression was too much. They split up. Mike Man cleans that up. Hexafire coming through from Sexy Savior. But that's all just blocked out. Graham, with the counter reversal, takes him down. Now he's up in the air for the Cursed Arm, trying to find the double kill. Severok is taken down, and Wizdude steals that. Dramamine shuts him down. Payload slowly making its way forward right now. Weeaboo Jones couldn't hold it off for much longer as Mike Man picks that one up.
What an amazing reversal. I mean, taking all the damage from a Ruckus Hexafire and just throwing it back into his face. I mean, that's got to feel good as an Androxus. Talk about using your kit appropriately. Ruckus just didn't have anywhere to go. I mean, he's just, I'm stuck shooting all these rockets at you, man. Now I know that I'm kind of screwed and I'm standing still, but I got to do it. And so he just has to pay the price. And the Reaper Androxus comes on and just does what he does best and gets the kills.
It does get those kills, cleans it up, and it looks like IC Gray holding things off right at their base. Dramamine got to hurt. Two kills for him. That's going to force Zenith Black back, and IC Gray make a great defense here. Weeaboo Jones, he's going aggressive, but you know, Fernando, he can do these things. He goes where he pleases.
Yeah, Fernando does go where he pleases. I mean, if you had a flaming lance, a shield, a flaming horse, and another shield when you got on top of it or off, I mean, would you go places where you wanted to go? I think we all would probably not really care about the bouncers at the clubs anymore. So I think Fernando definitely showing his superiority and being able to just take a lot of punishment and also dish it as well as supporting his teammates. It looks like Team Identity Crisis Gray is trying to find a way to go ahead and just defend this, but Weeaboo Jones is going down, and they're losing their main force.
Kill.
Unbelievable. Wizdude just says, no, five streak, quadra kill, We're getting this payload through, no matter what happens.
Snakey Snake takes the pentakill from him, though. Oh,
you gotta feel sad about that. Yeah.
That's gotta hurt. They do convert the payload, however. You gotta be salty after that. Your teammate takes the pentakill. I mean, I'd be salty.
I mean, would you, though, if you, like, need the kill? Like, if you're like, this could mean potentially $100,000. Are you really sad that he, you know, didn't get a pentakill? Or are you
gonna get that kill anyway. I mean, come on. It's all for the glory, you know?
Kill secures.
Dreamhack and all, but, you know.
Pentakill? Swedish babes, man.
Nothing could be. Nothing could be better. But, you know,
exactly.
<babes.
laughs> Exactly. As you see the flank coming in on the backside, Snakey Snake blinking in with the freeze. Unfreeze is now trying to take down. Actually, it looks like Rob Ford, who actually rocket boots is over to the side, but gets taken down by Snakey Snake anyway. So much for those boots with some rockets on the back. Didn't do any help against the Ice Queen. And now the Winter Witch is still alive, looking to try and make that 12 streak 13 as she's aggressing on the back line. But Sexy Savior and Weeaboo Jones forced to go ahead and make their way out, as this point can hardly be contested with just a few of them. Snakey Snake still here. Nice job to go ahead and avoid the damage from the salvo. But you know what? She's just doing too much. Too mobile, too effective offensively.
Oh,
Eevee showing the
Graham
difference.
Graham with the cursed arm long range takes down Dramamine on the point. Weeaboo Jones trying to do what he can to defend, but the rest of Zenith Black, they're coming in with a vengeance. There's the chicken. Graham picks up Weeaboo Jones. Wizdu finds another. That's three kills for the side of Zenith Black as they're trying to clean this up. Sexy Savior takes a fire, but it's not enough. All blocked out. And is a wipe. So close, 87 points for IC Gray.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't really matter, right? You know, it doesn't matter if you get to 99 and you only got one person standing and the enemy team has five and they're about to contest the point. It doesn't matter. And you can see there, who cares if you got 87 if your team is not able to defend for those last 13 points? I mean, if you're not there, you can't get those last 13.
You know,
and that's why, you know, what? Go ahead.
You know what
I
find weird? You know, we're still seeing resilience on the side of Zenith Black.
Right.
Find that really weird. We're not seeing any resiliences apart from on Severok on the side of IC Grey, despite the fact they had plenty of cards to spare. They've got three cards on everyone. They didn't pick up resilience at all on the rest of them, despite this being a freeze Eevee build.
Yeah, it is a freeze Eevee, and I think that's a little odd. I mean, I think most of them may have saw her early, like, she might have baited the opposite way and gone for not the freeze build, because I saw that earlier on, and so they might not have picked up resilience saying, you know what, she's not going freeze build, because she knows we can counter resiliences. And then they just got kind of baited as well. Reverse baited, essentially.
And I tell you what, it's costing them so far. Snakey Snake on an 18 streak right now. Going crazy on this one. Not able to counter that and shut her down. Weeaboo Jones, last one left. They're going to do good defense on this one. But the Hexafire, that's going to allow the payload to start moving on this one, as it decides to touch the ground, at least at this point.
Yeah, I know. It was doing like a wheelie, like a reverse
wheelie.
It was taking
flight, you know. Zenith Black pushed it so hard right at the start that it thought it was going to have, like, going to get lift off right there.
Exactly. Like a literal push. They literally pushed it so hard. That's what I like to see there. Snakey Snake trying to stay alive. 20 streak at the cost potentially of going in too deeply there. So she wants to make sure he stays back. Snake Snake doing a great job on the EV being so effective. Fernando wanted to run away immediately there and can't handle the pressure. It's just too good.
The cost of Eevee dying at this point right now would be huge. The bonus that Icy Gray could get from racking in that 20 streak Eevee is pretty large. So, you know, she's trying to look to stay alive. Mega Turret is popped on the payloads. They're trying to push this forward. Ice Storm goes through as well. Rob 4 taken very low. Finally taken out by Snakey Snake as he picks that one up and continues his rampage. Payload coming through. There's the Hexafire from Sexy Savior. Picks up one, picks up two, trying to look for the triple kill. Dramamine helping him out on that one, and it's Barrack running for the hills. Sexy Savior doesn't find the triples. Dramamine finds that, and they defend the payload. Great work by them.
Yep, they do, but they're going to have to make a bit of a change here. What we saw do well was the Hexafire was on point for Team Identity Crisis, and they were able to go ahead and make quick work of a lot of the members on Team Zenith Black, except for one. And that one is Snakey Snake. Obviously, the one they need to get down. 21 kills in a row. She's going to be worth a lot of credits, Tattle.
I know I mentioned that Snakey Snake needs to be careful of dying here to get to give up that bonus, but at the same time, you know, staying so far back that your team of 4v5, probably not the best of ideas at this point.
Oh, and also, who cares? Because, you know, they all have three burn cards.
It's now at the point where everyone has their burn cards now, too.
Right. Right, there's that small moment of advantage. We could talk about this for a second, too. Like, there's that small moment where you kind of start the game, and then there's, like, not everyone has their burn cards, but there's sometimes, like, when you can get that second or third burn card while the enemy team has one or two, that could be a nice little power curve for you, whether it's defensively or whether it's just utility-wise. We're seeing kind of that be where credits matter the most, and not towards, you know, the mid to late game of these matches now, because, of course, you get your burn cards and you keep them after death. So that's been a little bit of the change for this. There's, like, a middle kind of
it's the
burn card.
Smallest window of opportunity for teams to take a lead,
and very small.
From that point onwards, it's all about just strategy and how you play. I mean, we see it's all about using the right burn cards and then going forwards from there. And I tell you what, it's the side of Icy Gray winning the point for the first time this game, and actually looked to go their way very well.
Yeah, Icy Gray saying We're not letting you guys think that you're just going to run us over. We won the first game, remember? Drogo's coming in from the top. Misses! Oh, Dramamine's so close. What a good job to angle himself up there. Oh, man, he was inches away, Tattle. He was inches.
Just away from that, and now he's in danger as the rest of the Zenith Black team try and chase him down. This is going to be hard for Icy Gray to push forwards. They really needed that Dragon Punch kill. Dramamine gets one, but is traded back. There's a huge freeze coming through again from Snakey Snake, and that allows them to pick up a kill onto Severrock. And the payload has made its way towards the middle, but right now it's going through the choke point. If Zenith Black want to make any good defense here, despite with the kills, they need to find this accursed arm. That's going to slow things down. Rob Ford goes down to the hands of Graham as he's looking for Dramamine in the air. Reflect comes through, not able to land it. Pip as well trying to help out. Payload slowly moving back towards the big choke point, and Zenith Black, now the hold comes through.
Yeah, Dramamine just doing such work on the side of Team Zenith Black here. Actually, no, Team Identity Crisis. Yeah, just doing so well to be able to go ahead and use his height, his thrusters effectively. And you see the ultimate coming out. It misses again. Oh, my God. It was nice, though. He did it from cover. I like that. You see a lot of Drogos do that. They take the cover, so you can't really see where they're coming from. You hear the animation. But, wow, Dramamine gets the kill onto Mike Man as well. Rob Forb taking out Sneaky Snake. And Sexy Savior takes out Graham. This could be a full push.
He doesn't need that Dragon Punch when he lands shots like that. Chicken comes down, but Dramamine wasn't close to it. He stays up. He gets reveling. They push the payload. And now, Icy Gray, then they...
Making a comeback, I'm sure. Your mic is cutting out a little bit, Tattle. That's why I filled in the space for you. So, yeah, I'm sure you were saying something to the effect of making a big comeback.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, that's what I was saying. We're like, you were saying something hype about them making a comeback and this being an awesome game.
Page four of the script, right?
Exactly.
Line 26?
Line 27, man. Come on, stay with me here. Stay with me. Jeez. This is a production. Come on. So we've got the 5-6, a fantastic comeback so far. But will they be able to turn it all the way around? I mean, this is the loser's finals. This could mean Icy Gray, if they pull this off, they're into the grand finals. That would be huge for them and a big upset for Zenith Black.
Big upset indeed. Wizdude takes down Sexy Savior, but Dramamine, again, the man of the match so far, the one to look at. He picks up a double kill. He's looking for a triple onto Graham as well. Reflect comes through. He's got to be careful on that one. Huge. Taken down in the end, but I think he clipped someone there as well. Managed to pick up a kill. Cursed Arm comes down, and that's going to cause some issues for Weirboo Jones. The rest of the team, they're starting to recover. However, both teams practically wiped out so far in this fight, and they're going to go for a reset.
Huge reversal there by Graham to keep his team alive. If Graham would have gone down by the damage from Drogos and not popped that reversal at the right moment, it would have been GG because they would have had so much point contest, would have been able to aggress out in the front. But since Graham does a perfect reversal, gets the damage back onto Drogos, takes Dramamine out of the fight, makes it even. And now, you know, Team Zenith Black have a chance to make this an 8-5 lead.
8-5 lead, and Sexy Savior, he picks up two kills. Icy Gray, now they're starting to come back into this fight, trying to get control of this point once more. Dramamine having to run away from it for once. Severrock, he finds Wizdude with a great shot, though. Sexy Savior onto Raven. He actually backs up for the Dragon Punch, and he gets Mike Man taken down. They're going to get control of this point fight now. The rest of the team, they are trying to do what they can. Graham coming round from the flank, as well as Evie coming in. There's a great Ice Storm onto two, but Immortaled out. Dramamine gets down Graham. The objective goes to IC Gray, and they're looking for the victory here.
IC Gracie's victory in their palms. If they can go ahead and grab it after this payload push, they're going to be able to take themselves to the grand finals of this NA qualifier tournament. $100,000 potentially on the line for these teams. They are battling for it all. I cannot wait to see what happens in this next point. This payload push is going to mean so much to both of these teams, and we're going to have to see who can outplay the other. Both team comps looking good. Both players shining. Graham on the side of Zenith Black. Dramamine going hard with the Drogos on the side of Identity Crisis. Who's gonna come out the victor, Tattle?
Hexafire's popped, and honestly, I don't even know who can take this one at this point. I see Gray looking so strong on this comeback, scattering the side of Zenith Black, but Zenith Black, they're getting ready, set up in this position to try and hold the choke point. Cursed Arm comes out, not really dealing any damage onto anyone. No deaths so far on either side. Mega Turret is popped by the side of Zenith Black. That'll pick up Dramamine, at least Mike Man finding that first kill. And Snakey Snake, he finds Severok. That's going to put a halt to the attack of Icy Gray. There's a Hexafire as well coming out from Wizdude. That finds Robford. Zenith Black using a lot of cooldowns, but finding the kills.
Yeah, losing a lot of cooldowns, but they're slowly building back up. Dramamine's got his one-punch dragon moment here, and we're going to have to see how that affects. I'm going to say that ultimate could change the direction of this team fight in just a moment when he has the opportunity to use it. We've seen him hide behind the corner and try and pick somebody up, but Sexy
Savior, way too aggressive.
Yeah, taking out Graham, man. He gets caught. Androxus is what they needed. They needed that pressure, that offensive pressure, and now they have the freedom to go and ingress onto the back line of Pip. That's where Dramamine is right
savior.
Now.
They're all inside the base right now. Dramamine trying to do what he can. Wizdude does take him down, but the payload was pushed all this time. Wizdude finds the double onto Sexy Savior. 30 seconds left on the clock for this one. Severog, he's very low as well. Needs to jump out of this one. Graham does find that kill, and Wizdude in the back finds the kill onto Rodford. But look at this. Ultimates all on the side of IC Gray. Do they save them?
No, you go for it. You go for the win right now. You got momentum. Your team's here. You can get there. You can contest right before overtime. Go ahead and use it. Pop that Immortal. Make sure that you can stay alive. It's only at 80, but it will be up very soon. And just push this payload. Get yourself out of here, Dramamine says. Knocks back Sexy Savior, and Mike Man takes him down. Dramamine, however, takes down Graham. Huge play there. Wizdude, however, taking down Dramamine and Rob Ford as well. But Weeaboo Jones takes down Mike Man. The payload is moving, but it's only Weeaboo Jones. And it looks like that's going to be it in unless Sexy Savior has something to do. Can he save them in a sexy fashion, or is he just going to run away and stop this overtime from happening? And it looks like they didn't take my advice. They didn't use all their ults. They decided not to use them and save it for this next capture
point. If they had and not made it through, this would have been game. It is now 100 ults on everyone right now. It is 7-7. The person who wins this next point takes the game. Zenith Black holding on by an inch of their life as IC Gray are looking towards that finals.
We've seen the Canyon be valuable for not only the Eevee, but the Drogos on the side of Identity Crisis, but a Snakey Snake back on that 7 streak, and don't forget about Wizdude, who's on an 11 streak himself. We saw the flank happen for both teams on the left and the right-hand side near the waterfall, and it looks like it's happening again. One Punch Dragon comes up into the air. Is it going to land? Is it going to connect? It does not connect, but Graham does connect with his shots to take down Saravok, and that's advantage Team Zenith Black.
Chicken comes through. Graham picks up Weeaboo Joan. Mike Man onto Sexy Savior. Wizdude with a Hexafire as well. He's going to find that kill. Rob Ford at least picks up one, but he's going to drop very shortly afterwards. And it looks like Zenith Black take a commanding lead on this fight.
And all ultimates used on both teams. There is not going to be a chance to come back at it with some amazing ability. It's going to have to be skill, tactical positioning, and timing that's going to win this one for Team Identity Crisis if they want to go ahead and take the series. Otherwise, Zenith Black is going to close in on this game and make it a 3-game set with a chance to go ahead and win themselves. It's 90 points on the capture, and it looks like there's only 10 left, but Snakey Snake gets the kill on the Saravok, but Sexy Savior takes out Reveling and Mike Man. Wizdude going ahead, following up on Dramamine. It's 3-3. It really comes down to this. The capture point is being supported by Team Zenith Black, but it looks like they may not have enough. Weebu Jones is there as well, and it's Weebu Jones versus Androxus and Ruckus. I think Weebu Jones can't handle it, and it looks like it's going to go the way of Zenith Black. They take the second game in the set, and they put themselves into the third match with a chance to go to the finals and face off against Team Ronin, who put them in the losers' finals to begin with. Zenith Black, whew, gotta be wiping their foreheads there with the perspiration, because that was almost end of tournament.
That was so close to the end for Zenith Black right there, but I see Gray not able to pull it through at the end. The dream comeback, the Cinderella story that would have been off the tournament so far, not able to pull it through, and I think a big part of that, Dramamine wasn't able to hit anyone with that Dragon Punch.
That was
really
a huge issue.
Cost them.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It was a huge issue because you cannot even quantify how much of a difference it is having 4 versus 5 players. The things that makes you do as the team who has 4, and the freedom that allows you to kind of do in terms of your positioning. You free up on the team that has 5, and it really helps the snowball in this scenario, and he wasn't able to pick it up. I mean, great play. 73,000 damage. You know, 18 to 19 deaths. We saw him die quite a bit, probably because he went in with those Dragon Punch ultimates wanting to use them, you know, like a pro. He mentioned, I'm going to hit these or I'm going to die trying. And pretty much he pulled a 50 cent, you know, and he died trying, because apparently that guy's not rich anymore. I don't know. I mean, I have heard that he has went bankrupt. But the truth is, you see these teams both having moments. And Tattle, you know, it comes down to moments to see who's going to win. But what do these moments need to consist more of for any of these teams to take the advantage? Like, what moments do they need to make happen for IC Gray and also, Zenith Black to really go into the grand finals here?
It's all about those pivotal turning ultimates. You need that ultimate to just wipe the team out. They're the game-making plays right now. And I feel this is the story of IC Gray right now. Look at the damage and stuff across the board, as well as the credits. You know, they were actually quite even in terms of teams, but the deaths and the kills, there's a disparity there, which is pretty much the story of IC Gray the whole tournament so far, as far as we've seen. Behind in the game, and yet they still either take the win or take it unbearably close.
Yeah, and that's going to be really interesting for our third and final set, which really has it all down to the line. Both teams facing elimination. There's a possibility for it to go either way. We've seen Control go to both Identity Crisis Gray, who just lost this game, and Zenith Black, who are the recent winners. But we'll have to wait and see how that plays out in the following matchup. We're going to be on Enchanted Forest, so we'll see how this new map changes and maybe some new characters. Who knows? Stay tuned to find out all of that information and see who goes ahead into the grand finals to face Ronin right after this. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, champions of the realm, to another game of Paladins. This time, it's a game 3. And of course, this is the loser's finals, so this one has all the marbles on it for all of these teams involved, Identity Crisis and Team Zenith Black. Now, on the left-hand side, Zenith Black is representing Ruckus, Androxus, Barrick, Avi, and Pip, Wizdude, Graham, Mike Man, Snakey Snake, and Reveling, all representing those characters in order, as well as on the side of Team Identity Crisis Gray, we've got Ruckus, Pip, Drogos, Fernando, and Barrick being represented by Sexy Savior, Sarah Vok, Dramamine, Weeaboo Jones, and Rob Ford in that order as well. And of course, today I'm joined by my co-commentator, Tattle.
Question of whether they'll see victory or whether they'll see defeat in this one really is that comes down to this final game in the best of three.
Yeah, I see a good opportunity here for both of these teams to make an impact in this game and to potentially find themselves a way into the championship. Snakey Snake, however, showing the dominance that he's been demonstrating with that Eevee ever since the last game when he switched up the picks for him. Really a fantastic choice, I think, and really brought Zenith Black into this game, allowing them to win that second game, which, you know, didn't look like it was going their way for a moment, and now absolutely pivotal in their success.
We are seeing resilience on two members of Zenith Black. Again, I just don't even know. It's the start of the game as well.
I don't know.
I'm so confused.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know either. I don't know. I don't think we'll be able to understand that, Tattle. I don't think we have the minds as commentators to really understand these pro plays. You know what I mean? And I think we just will have to give that up for right now, because it doesn't make sense to us here at the table looking at it, trying to figure out, because the resilience is just being a reduction in crowd control. We're not seeing so much crowd control on the other team to warrant it in our eyes. And so we're seeing it consistently picked up and kind of just being a little befuddled at the choice. But anyways, it looks like the capture point, however, is going their way. So maybe who cares, right? If it's working for them, it's working for them. And you don't have to really question something that's working, because obviously it's working.
Zenith Black coming ahead in that one. They take the capture point. Wiz Dude with a nice flank comes around. There's the Hex of Fiery Pops. Graham takes the kill. But there's a Dragon Punch in his back. Tramamine takes him down. Does get taken down for it, but what a play. I mean, I'd take that any day.
I mean, I take that any day as well, but I mean, I'm surprised Wiz Dude took that. He was just standing there. I mean, it's a long windup. I would have at least expected him to either hover. He must have just had a little bit of tunnel vision in his fight he was having. And props to, props to Dramamine just like setting that up so that he was really at an angle where it was so hard to miss. I mean, it's kind of like face-to-face Dragon Punch there. He's going to land that one.
Yeah, he hits him right in the back and takes him out. And Zenith Black, commanding push right now in the start of this game. They're just pushing this forward. Mega Turret's going to keep them pushing as well. Actually, no one of the payloads, so they're not going to keep it pushing. They drop the Mega Turret, and Reveling just leaves it to go for these kills instead. Trying to pick off Dramamine in the air there. That's going to be tricky to do, as it looks like Rob Ford on the payload now, keeping it locked down, starting to move it back.
Yeah, and the Exifier does come out from the ruckus of Sexy Savior there, looking to try and make himself a savior of this payload push. But who knows if that's eventually going to work out for them, as, of course, Reveling and Squad on Team Zenith Black have kind of prioritized going to the right. I mean, I think, Tattle, that's a result of them looking to say, okay, the payload's kind of in a bad choke point, so we want to maybe just forget about it. It's not going to move too far back, and we can go to the right-hand side, and that way we'll get a better vantage point, have some more cover, and kind of force them to fight us, not being so exposed by that payload, which a lot of people feel obligated to stand by.
They've had some more cover, but it's not worked out for them, as the payload is now pushing all the way back to an even worse choke point in this one. They've lost all that ground they gained in the last push. Sexy Savior finds a kill onto Mikeman. The rest of the team trying to do what they can. Graham with a great Cursed Arm Snipe finds a double kill. That was a sharpshooter shot right there, as they're now turning their attention to Dramamine. Graham finds the triple kill. He's now looking for another. Still hungry for more right now.
This is huge. Fernando's not up for another 4 seconds. Drogo's not up for another zero, but expect an immediate expectorate knockback coming out very, very soon on the side of Drogo's, who's got to get on his mount, but get there first. The knockback can't happen if he's not in range. It looks like he's going, and there's the knockback finally, but is it going to be enough? The cripple and the ultimate comes out from Eevee and Snakey Snake, and Wizdude, Reveling, Wizdude, and Graham get alternating kills onto Seravik, Sexy Savior, and Dramamine, and this push is going to be successful. 4-0 zip start. For Team Zenith Black.
Huge Hexafire coming out from Wizdude there, really knowing the timing on that one. Takes it down right now, and he's just pushing his team closer to that victory.
Oh, man, just a fantastic play. I mean, what is Zenith Black doing? You're going to love this, too. Another resilience on Wizdude.
It's gotta be a meme at this point. You know, maybe they're just taking it just because they know that I'm just head in my hands right now.
It's like we're listening to Tattle's responses every time we get this, and it's like really pumping us up. Like he's going so hype.
If these guys know, but tilting the commentator sadly won't help them win the game. You know, you gotta tilt the players.
You start talking louder, you start making it more hype, it becomes more intense, you know, interesting, and then they're like, yeah, let's go, let's play. So maybe that's what they're going for. Dragon Punch wind up coming out from the side of Dramamine. Is he gonna find it? But Reveling, no, dodges. Effectively and gets out of the way. Oh, almost very close there. And Snakey Snake gets the kill on the Sexy Savior.
Mega Turret comes out in the meanwhile from the side of IC Gray, but it's not worked out for them. Rob Ford, he finds a double kill of his own on the other side. Snakey Snake does take him down and actually finds Seravok as well for that double kill. And they're now turning their attention to Weirbo Jones, who also drops down, giving Zenith Black control of the point.
Zenith Black strong control. A nice blink freeze there by the Eevee. Taken out is Sexy Savior by Graham, supporting that Eevee with that critical damage. And, of course, the CC, which we would have found not effective on the side of Team Zenith Black because they've all got resiliences, which would have reduced all that CC. But, of course, the members on Identity Crisis, not so much. Actually, Sexy Savior doesn't have resilience. So one of the only members, aside from Dramamine, who are actually susceptible to Eevee's Blink Freeze, that Frigid Field card that she's picked up, allowing her to freeze her opponents and then, of course, unfreeze herself and then attack them while they are still frozen. Very powerful for a team who has the setup potential.
You know, someone just pointed out, this is the reason it all makes sense now. I was wondering because no character had any CC on their kit built in, but actually, Dramamine has Viscosity 4, the card that allows his Lugis to give 60% slows on them by the when hit by the radius and the explosion from it. So it all makes sense now. Zenith Black, we understand you.
Yeah. I'm not sure he had. Did he have that every single? I mean, was it always for Dramamine though? I mean, I don't know. There are a lot of interesting mechanics there. I mean, you look at Eevee. And yes, she's slowed, but I mean, a lot of these characters, when they use their movement abilities, you know, negate the slows. They remove the debuffs. I mean, I think it's, yes, it's targeted. Yes, you don't want to get hit with a 60% slow for 3 seconds. But a lot of times you're going to use a movement ability to get back onto the point if you really need to get there quickly anyways. A lot of those will remove the debuffs. And again, is it worthwhile? It's not that it's bad or good, right? We see the purpose. We knew that. Yeah. But is it more worthwhile than having blast shields on your team?
I'm honestly not sure. I mean, it seems to be working out for them at the moment. They are at a card advantage in this one, pushing forward for the next payload. It's definitely working out for them right now. But for sure, it's odd. And you know, it didn't work for them previously when we saw all those blast shields come out. But it's just dominating how they're taking down the side of Icy Gray. And on top of that, you know, you mentioned you can just use your movement ability to disable that. And, you know, we see that, you know, you cannot use movement abilities to get out the hard CC of the chicken. So I'd understand, you know, when resilience used to stop that, it's understandable that you take that because that was the only real way of getting out of it to counter it. Whereas, as you mentioned, you can just use your movement ability if you really want to get out of that slow.
Right. So, I mean, again, it's like, it's not that it's bad. Like, yeah, we'll negate the slow. That's great. It's not going to negate the knockback. We know that. So that's the main issue, right? It's not that you're slowed. It's that you're knocked back so far. But again, is it better than some of the other options? I mean, that's why you see certain characters getting picked and never seeing other characters. It's like, it's not that Sky's horrible, right? Sky's okay. But you're just never going to pick Sky over some of the other characters that are clearly stronger. And that's kind of what we're looking at here.
That is so unfortunate for the side of Icy Gray on that fight, as the Immortal comes down just too late to save his team from Wizdude's Hexafire. 78 points. Icy Gray was sneaking that one through, but Zenith Black finally turned their attention onto it and pick up the kills, starting to capture the point now. They're looking for the victory. Sexy Savior finds the kill they need to onto Wizdude. It's currently a 3-4 as Sexy Savior goes down. 75 points. It's getting mighty close. There goes Serevok as well. Rob Ford at least finds a kill. Dragon Punch is coming in, however. That's a kill onto Mike Man. The Kim picking that one up. Graham with the Great Cursed Arm picks up Weeaboo Jones. However, it's 89, 96. They're going to take the point. Zenith Black, take the game.
GG, man. What a fantastic game. Just a 9-0 sweep. Convincingly taking this third set, saying, listen, we let you guys come back in, but we are the team that deserves to go to the finals. And hey, how can you argue with a 9-0 play? Jaded Forest might have just been the difference there. And of course, the difference in maps now, bringing in 3 maps instead of just the 1 Glacier Keep, allows it to make a lot more of a kind of a stratagem take effect for these teams on different scenarios. So you're not just seeing the same type of tactics being played because the map is static. You're seeing not only different characters, but seeing different map tactics, different positioning, different abilities being used in tandem with other abilities or used in different ways to affect them because of the structure of where they're fighting is different. So very good job by Zenith Black to take a convincing win in that last set, make sure everybody knows, hey, we deserve to be in these finals, and it's going to be a rematch against Ronan for them.
And for such a short game, look at Graham and Reveling. What is that? 20 kills on that Androxus.
That's not a lot.
Well, for an 11
I'm just kidding.
Game.
I'm joking. I'm joking, man. You're like, what is that? No.
I'm still mind-boggled. So 20 kills in 11 minutes. What is that?
But two deaths as well. I mean, that's the key. You know, he's got pretty much the lowest deaths on his team. Not only that, he's got 10-1 for Reveling, 20-2 for Graham. I mean, that's impressive as heck. And, of course, a 22 streak. I mean, solid stream. Solid play by Graham. I mean, I'm loving what he's doing and taking.
Solid stream.
solid stream. Solid play by Graham and putting himself in a position to really be effective against Team Ronan in the finals. Anything you're looking forward to particularly about these finals before we send the viewers off and get ready for that final match of the day?
I mean, at this point, I think everyone's just waiting for that finals. You know, after that last game, I mean, we were waiting. Everyone was just like on the edge of their seat, just like, this one's going to be good. This one's going to be a close. It was a shutout. I'm sorry. But I see Gray. They showed up and put all their heart into it. Zenith Black shut them out in the end. They're going to go forwards to the finals. And everyone now, they're now waiting for the Ronan and Zenith game to give them that excitement they were just waiting for and just left cold turkey from that game.
I see Gray. I see Black. We see some potential in your guys' future. Keep it up. Keep your teams together. We love the way you competed and definitely created probably the first Paladins meme to be one of many here that we felt very fun matches watching.
Hey, don't
guys
forget Cassie Ball.
Yeah, of course. Well, who can forget that? But, I mean, congratulations to IC for making it this far and being very entertaining in the process. So great picks, great stuff. Shout-outs to all of their team members on both sides, Black and Gray. And congrats to teams in the Black who are going to be moving on to the finals to face Team Ronan. This is going to be a best of five. So if you haven't had enough Paladins today, which I'm sure nobody has had enough Paladins for today. I mean, we've only been streaming for about, I don't know, like 10 hours, it feels like. We have five potential games coming on. And if Team Zenith Black actually wins against Ronan, we're going to reset that bracket. So potentially 10 games more, guys. You're going to be watching. Everybody, aren't you excited? No, we're kidding. We are excited. It's been a long stream, but you know what? The quality of the stream has been extremely great. So many good games, so much fun to be had. And of course, we're all in good spirits about Paladins just taking off and becoming this great hub of people watching to support the competitive scene moving forward. My name's Rainday. You're with me and Tattle for today, and the finals will be starting real soon against Ronan versus Zenith Black. See you guys in a bit.